Let's talk about abortion. Now, this is the perfect topic for my show because there's nothing women love more than men discussing what women should be allowed to do with their own bodies. Right, ladies? Shh, don't answer. I got this. Some lawmakers in the US have called for constitutional amendments to ban it. Now, there are countries in the world where abortion is banned. So what's that like? It's places where religious ideology dictates the law, where women risk back alley operations to end pregnancies. It's places like Ireland? That's right, in 1983, Ireland passed a constitutional amendment banning abortion, their 8th Amendment, and the first that doesn't pertain to alcohol or leprechauns. Ireland's also home to an old friend of mine, Tara Flynn. She's a great stand-up comedian, but lately, she's joined the campaign to repeal the 8th.
The 8th Amendment basically don't have ovaries and don't determine your own future.
Don't get knocked up.
If you procure abortion pills in Ireland, if you have an abortion on Irish soil, the penalty's 14 years.
14 years.
A fetus or embryo has exactly the same rights as the woman who's carrying it.
But on the upside, the fetus can't get an abortion either.
So no, that's
equal
true.
Rights.
Although they can get lawyers.
Really? Who gets them the lawyers?
I'm sure there's a whole, you know, fetus lawyer firm.
Fetus.
And fetus, yeah.
And Tara has a very personal reason for joining the movement.
My name is Tara Flynn. I had an abortion. I was shamed into silence. I was told I was a criminal.
But wait, if Tara had an abortion is illegal in Ireland, how did she get it done?
The euphemism for having an abortion in Ireland is going to England. 12 women a day, 12 pregnant people come to Britain and have abortions. It's a very surreal thing to go for healthcare to another country.
Look, we get it, ladies. When you want something, you're gonna find a way. So just like some American women are forced to travel to different states, Irish women go hundreds of miles for healthcare, if they can afford it.
I'm one of the lucky ones. I had a credit card and I was able to book a flight. But people who don't have any money or people who don't have visas because they're asylum seekers or whatever, they are still using coat hangers in Ireland.
Or starving themselves or drinking bleach or... Jesus, these women are serious. So to provide an alternative, organisations have sprung up to bring medical care to them. One group flies abortion pills in on drones. Another group takes women out on boats into international waters where abortion laws don't apply. But Tara's contribution is raising awareness by telling her story. And she does it like only a stand-up comic could.
I have to keep a modicum of seriousness around it. But when I tell my own story, I want to put in the jokes. I want to put in the fact that, you know, this all happened because of an unsatisfactory fumble in 2006.
Mm.
It was on a beanbag.
Do I know him? I've known you for many years.
You don't.
I'm going to throw a few names. Jason.
No.
Brendan. That would be gross, right?
It's no one you know.
Who's old abortion Joe?
I mean...
Paul.
No, stop it.
Beanbag Paul.
I'm going to tell my story my way because it was a horrible decision to have to make. It was a really traumatic time. Laughter's healing, laughter's brilliant, and that's how I want to talk about my story from now on.
Now, it's fine for Tara to joke about abortion, but then she tried to lure me in.
Hit me with some jokes. Because, you see, as a comedian, I don't know if you've ever tried to address this issue in your stand-up, but when you say the A word or abortion, it tends to just, you know, take all the oxygen out of the room.
She's setting you up, Jim. Don't give in. The internet will attack.
I mean, how would you address it comedically?
Ah, fuck it.
I've heard stories of drones.
Yeah.
Bringing the pills in.
I've heard of that too.
That's amazing because, like, with modern technology, because in the olden days, the drone would just bring in a coat hanger. There's talk now of bringing in abortion cruises.
They're not exactly abortion cruises.
Do you have the abortion early on in the cruise where you can enjoy the rest of your trip? Or do you go, I'm going to get drunk and then I'll have it right at the end and I'll be sick at home? I'm not ruining my holiday.
These aren't holidays.
As a comedian, would you perform in the abortion cruise?
If I could offer someone support through laughter with my own story.
No blue material.
No
blue material. It's a cruise. You got to work clean.
But not everyone's laughing. Ireland's religious conservatives are fighting the repeal effort. They support the abortion ban and the laws that force thousands of Irish women to travel every year. People like this guy, conservative politician Justin Barrett. He's the leader of Ireland's National Party and founder of the controversial Abortion Never campaign.
How it became a women's rights issue is beyond my understanding.
Pure bloodlust.
Abhorrent.
Murderous lunatics.
Disgusting.
They are baby killers.
Now that might sound like an extreme position, but Barrett just represents the abortion laws that are in Ireland's constitution. I had to talk to this fucking guy. And I have an idea.
I'm in Dublin, home of the anti-abortion advocate Justin Barrett. Now it'd be very convenient for Mr. Barrett if I just interviewed him here, but I thought, no, let's make him fly to London. So he has to endure the same kind of bullshit that every Irish woman has to go through if they want an abortion.
We wanted to make sure that Barrett felt the full pain of the trip into London. So we brought along one of our riders to annoy the shit out of him.
Hi, how are you?
Dell.
Hi, how are you?
You're in good hands.
I'll see you at the hotel.
Okay.
All right. How was your flight?
There was a bit of a delay. Quite a while.
Are you hungry?
I'm a bit hungry, yeah.
I got some tuna sandwiches.
No fish of any kind, I can't.
No. I made this myself.
I actually don't care.
I make a special tuna sandwich with the cheese, and then I put it in my pocket. I run really hot, so it gets warm. Is this bothering you, the smell? My wife. Hello? The keys? I didn't take them. I don't have the keys. I don't have them. I'm in the car with a guy, his name's Justin. He would...
Oh, no.
I'm in the middle of work right now. It's kind of unprofessional. She's great. I can't get divorced. Should have signed a prenup, that's all I'm saying. Are you here?
Here we go.
Okay, I'll be right back, Justin. Just hang tight. If you change your mind, that sandwich is in the back there. This guy has the worst breath. Okay. That's not even a hotel. It's all running.
Are we going to be late here?
We're almost there.
Good.
So we're lost? Are you a drinker?
No.
You like musicals?
No.
What's that little house?
It's a public laboratory.
That's pretty nice. Probably smells the same as the rest, but... I just got these Ugg boots. You want to try them on?
No, I will not.
Just touch that. Doesn't smell. I sweat a lot, but my feet don't sweat for whatever reason. Every part of my body sweats. Turn into a long day. Just don't mention this to Jim. That'd be great. That's my wife again. Hello? Okay, listen, calm down. You always get mad at me for like these little things. I want to tell you something. There's a guy named Justin, and I've been talking to him, and I was talking about our marriage and stuff, and I think... I'll have to talk to you later, but I think that maybe we're not going to... maybe not be married anymore or something.
Okay. We're very close. I think we should just walk.
We're not walking.
Justin had a bit of a rough trip in with Dell.
thanks for traveling here.
You know, we put him through the ringer, but he is here. I'll keep an open mind.
So I would say that you're anti-abortion?
Baby killers!
Oh yeah, I don't have a problem with that statement. Abortion is murder.
Over 80% of people in Ireland believe that abortion is okay if the mother's life is in danger. 72% and upwards agree if there's a situation like rape.
I don't know if that polling figure is accurate, but abortion is murder.
Do you believe that women who get elective abortions should be punished?
Maximum penalty is 14 years. I would keep the 14 years. People casually use abortion, like, oh, I'm going on holiday. I think I'll go to have an abortion so it doesn't upset my holiday plans. A woman having a casual abortion is a murder.
What should happen to the doctors who give the abortions?
Death penalty.
They should get the death penalty?
Yes.
That's it. Suddenly it occurred to me. Why am I asking a politician, especially one who studied fucking accounting? Why should an accountant decide the rules for women's healthcare? Get me out of here.
We're good?
Yeah.
We're good.
All right. Justin, on behalf of the women of Ireland, enjoy your flight home. But actual experts say that Ireland's laws are unsafe and that they violate women's fundamental human rights. So that's the real choice that countries or US states face when they make abortion laws. Will all women have access to safe medical care or not?
This is the story of about 200,000 of us, women living in Ireland who have been ignored.
Ah, abortion. The ultimate Irish goodbye. Now, the date has been set for the country to vote on repealing the Eighth Amendment. The referendum is on May 25th, so Ireland, get out there and vote. And maybe, just maybe, at the end of that rainbow, you might find a pot of abortions.